Hello! What if I tell you that you can make real money with open source? We all love open source. That's why we contribute to it, because we believe in the cause. But once you get involved and it becomes quite time consuming, it's totally understandable that you might want to get paid for your effort. Having a way to get paid also gives the possibility to other developers who might not be able to contribute in their free time otherwise. I mean, we're not supposed to work for free every time, right? So, my name is Leonardo, and in this channel, I talk about open source and web development. Today, I want to share with you some tips and tricks and advices on how to get a consistent stream of income by having fun in contributing to your favorite open source projects. The most common way is obviously by having a sponsor or via crowdfunding. That's why I want to tell you first the least common way and then come back to sponsorships. Now, you'll be surprised, but you can already get paid for contributing to open source without even changing your job during the day. How? Well, if your daily project uses some open source libraries, you can ask your employer to let you contribute to them. The time you will spend on the open source project will in fact be time you're spending on improving your private source app for your job, and this will benefit the company itself. That's a good reason, right? This means your current employer will in fact pay you for open source, and you will have more fun rather than wasting time with boring projects or your clients. If you need some more leverage in the pitch with your boss, you can also let him realize, or her, we're inclusive, you can let them realize that contributing to open source for your company is also good advertisement. Other contributors might notice your company and see that you value open source, and this can convert in new candidates for your company. Besides, your internal HR or technical recruiters can already see the job or how the new applicants work because the open source, right? I mean, that's a huge win-win condition for you and for your boss. A slightly different way on the same page is by asking your boss to put open source your currently private repository. Where is the advantage? Well, all the advantages of open source come to the rescue. Your project will be public and open to contributions from other developers all over the world. Isn't that extra coding power for free? If you need some examples, there are already some large companies giving time for their employees to work on open source. Some examples are Netflix, PayPal, or Zalando. If you want to know more, I leave 3 links in the description of this video. You can check them out, and the company themselves give all the details. On a completely different page, if you're the owner of an open source project and your target is usually other companies, this opens up to some interesting opportunities. Let me explain. You can think of offering hosting or premium customer support to your client. If you want an example, the project Redis, the really popular real-time database, is already doing them all, and it's successful. A more code-oriented solution can be using the open core model. If you want some more details, I'll leave something in the description. Basically, it's the core of your application being open source, but you can monetize on add-ons and custom upgrades. That's also another option of getting paid while working on kind of open source projects. Okay, it didn't take long after all. It's now time to talk about sponsors, what I mentioned in the beginning. GitHub already runs a popular project called GitHub Sponsors. And as the name says, it's GitHub giving you a platform where everyone can fund and sponsor other projects almost from all around the world. Technically, it's not available worldwide, but it's already active in 68 different countries, and you can see the list in the official website. However, if your country is not supported yet, they suggest you to join the waiting list to also get notified when it will be supported. Pretty much like you should subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, You might click the notification bell so you get notified when new videos are out. It's pretty much the same, isn't it? Oh, you can also leave a like. A good reason to get involved in this project is that GitHub claims to take zero fees. This means if someone donates you 10 euros, you receive 10 euros. If they donate $25, you receive $25. How convenient! One more good reason is that the platform is pretty much internal to GitHub, so you don't have to use other external providers such as Patreon or Kickstarter, which they also take a fee on your donations. As a side note, I don't want to ruin the party, but don't forget that in many countries, donations are still subject to taxation, so you have to pay taxes, and GitHub doesn't offer you the service for that, so make sure you follow the laws of your country. It's important. A similar and really popular option is OpenCollective, which also claims to take zero fee, like GitHub sponsors. I have to say, I haven't studied it well, so I'm not gonna tell you something wrong, but I suggest you to also check out this other option, because it's probably valuable. Actually, if you already know something about OpenCollective, or you have an opinion on which one is better between OpenCollective or GitHub sponsor, please let me know, you can write a comment down below. Okay, so, if everything I said until this point is not enough for you, there's also an extra and direct way of getting money with open source. Let me explain. If you do quality contributions, you have a big chance of getting noticed by some recruiters of other companies who may pay you more than you're actually getting. I talk about that in detail in another video. You should see the pop-up here, I guess, and also the link will be in the description. So, like the taxes paragraph, I will also have to ruin the party a little bit once more for the last time in this video. Sorry. Having someone paying you real money for your open source project is indeed great, but it also comes with a cost.
Remember, with great power comes great responsibility.
If you started open source for passion, because you wanted to learn, or just out of curiosity, you most always had fun in contributing, because you wanted to help someone. Now, if someone is paying you, you might feel some pressure. Getting paid also means having more responsibilities. I mean, for someone it can be more than fine. You get paid, you have responsibility, you have to deliver. But it might not be for everyone, and someone might still want to keep open source as a hobby. So think about it twice. I think you want to avoid burnout, right? You better avoid that. I've been in that phase. It's not good. The last thing I want to tell you is actually more important than everything else. Because if you want to get paid for open source, you also need a project. You better check this other video where I'll help you finding a good project for you. Finding one can be really hard, and I've been in that phase as well. That's why I want to help you. So, leave a like on this video, if you haven't subscribed already, do that now, and go check this other video here. See you there!